And then coming in at number five, another young guy who's definitely proven his place on the PGA Tour. He's one of the world's best. We have Viktor Hovland at number five this week.
Hovland is just sort of slightly out of the limelight, but we all know he's finished like third, the last three events he's played. And how's he do that? He hits it long and straight, but he's a really good iron player, and he's sort of fixed his chipping. He was an average chipper, and he's just becoming a tour player. And Hovland, look, he's better than these other guys. I saw him play at Charlotte. He was in the pit in the final day with Jason Duffner, who had a terrible day that day. But Duffner texted me and said, this is the real deal, this guy. He knows exactly what's going on out here, and watch out. So Hovland is playing very well. Like I said, there's only a dozen guys can win this tournament, and he's one of them.
Yeah, that was the big thing for him, was his chipping, and he finished third at the Valspar. I think that was really the week when all of his hard work on his chipping paid off, and he even talked about it afterwards, saying that that had been the flaw, and for the first time he felt really confident with it. His scrambling stat doesn't reflect the fact that he's got so much better over the past couple of weeks, and it's going to be a part of the game that could be important this week.
Very important. There's going to be greens that are missed. There's going to be crosswind. Diane, when I think of, I already said this once, I'm going to say it again. I'm not big on the super speed guys this week. We're going to talk about a few of them coming up here. I want those rhythmical swings and these crosswinds. When you play holes with crosswinds, think Rory McIlroy's tempo.